some guidance and helping them out. And
from what I can gather, what happened here was this is Jim's brother, Mike Austin.
Jim's brother-in-law.
What's it, Mike? John.
John Austino.
And John previously owned a karate facility. It was on Route 130 in Collingswood. And he closed it up to work a thing out with the youth of Gloucester, the troubled youth of Gloucester. And Jim was explaining something to us on the rate. It's like $30 a month or something like that, correct?
Right, Bruce. And also they're having people that can sponsor a kid for $30 a month. And he could sponsor them for a year. And
what happens is Jimmy comes up with the sponsor. So if anyone is interested in a sponsorship, which is $30 per month for some troubled youth in the city, they would send in their donation to P.O. Box 416 in Gloucester City, and that would be care of the Harry P. Furry Memorial Youth Center, correct?
Correct.
Okay, and if this is on Burlington, and is this Mercer Street?
Mercer and Burlington.
Burlington. And this only opened up only December the 1st, I think Jim had told us.
Yeah, this is a great facility. They did a wonderful job. The outside looks gorgeous, and so does the inside.
I mean, they've done a very good job. Well, what we're going to do, we're going to take a break right now. When we come back, we're going to talk to Jim, and maybe John will get a chance. Welcome back. This segment is brought to you by TKR Cable, that's serving both Brooklawn, Gloucester, and Mount Ephraim. With us, we have Jim Furry. Jim is the founder and the brother of Harry Furry, who this center is named after. Jim, give us a little bit of the background on this.
Well, I've been trying to keep Harry's name alive ever since he died 10 years ago. And through the efforts of my brother-in-law, John Austino, we're now open officially as of December 1st. We're planning on a grand opening. We've got a lot of contributors. The biggest thing we got right now to try to keep it rolling is Kenny McAdams has formed a cozy morning night coming up January 22nd, this Sunday. We're pretty near sold out. There is some tickets available. You can get them by contacting Kenny. Without the efforts of Kenny with the cozy morning night, the golf tournament that Kenny runs, the bus tournament, and a lot of businesses in town that has donated materials, money, and a lot of other things to keep Harry's name alive. And as you can see with the crowd, that we're starting to the response with the kids in the neighborhood, a lot of kids that were bad, real bad. I mean, they were really
not like us.
really turn them around. They had a different vocabulary, but I got to give the biggest credit to John Osteo. Without him, you know, the instructions that he's given to these kids, we could never do it.
Now I don't know a whole lot about karate, but the big thing karate does, that teaches discipline, and that's probably one of the biggest assets, because if a child doesn't get discipline at home or throughout their school system or whatever it may be, it's an independent learning situation on their behalf where they can learn some discipline, correct?
That's correct. I think the biggest thing that has to be bestowed, a lot of people are saying you're going to make the bad kids better, but it's not really that with karate. As John can tell you better than I, that it's more to teach them, as you're saying, respect, discipline, and they've turned an awful lot of these kids around. I mean, John teaches them more than most parents could ever do. Because he's had the patience, he's been doing it for 30 years. He sure has seen a lot of these kids around.
Yeah, and as I noticed, you're talking about respect and discipline. When they walk in, they all bow before they enter this area.
John makes them do 25 push-ups, so they learn to bow real quick.
Now, also, this isn't only about karate, right?
Yeah.
You have some other things that's going to be happening.
Right now, we got karate. We just finished the rooms in the back. We put in some donated carpet by some donated installers, and we're going to start the ceramics, chess, Scrabble. We got some fellas going to teach. Jack Simler from Town of Catherine's going to teach the kids ham radio. Can't remember the list now right now, but the list goes on. Peggy's very involved with it, my sister, which is also a brother, obviously, to Harry.
Now, I have a question. Should some parent or some citizen feel as though they know some child that may be troubled and may need your support, would they contact you? How would they go about talking to you about this?
Well, we have some businesses that are sponsoring kids. They can either be sponsored. They can call John at 742-0123. Call the fence company at 456-7673 and ask for Peggy. And we'll try to get them a sponsor, and sponsor. It costs $30 a month to sponsor a kid.
And normally it's like, what, $43, $45 normally most places, right?
Well, John, when he closed up his other school, was $49. Some of them are up as high as $75. And the biggest expense goes towards the insurance, because we wouldn't be able to be open without the insurance.
Right.
And, you know, all the kids are covered with insurance.
Is that McAdams Insurance at 742-0505?
No, Kenny couldn't do it. But it was a referral, Kenny,
right.
Though. But, yes, it's going over very well. You know, I think he's up to 57 students right now, and they're all age brackets. Many of them are young that need it, you know.
If the cameraman gets a chance, if he could take a look at the crowd, I mean, this is a pretty good crowd here, even.
Oh, yeah, and this is normal. Monday through Thursday, 6 to 10.
Jim, I'd just like to say that I know you have a way of getting the best out of people, and I know you got a lot of volunteers to help out on this project, and I have to give you credit. And I sit here and I look at the kids and things, and I think back of Harry, and Harry was a good friend of mine and a good friend of Gloucester and Brooklawn and, you know, all the people here, and I just think this is great.
Well, I appreciate that, but I think one of the biggest things is when it's for kids, it's easy to get support. And as you know, Harry died without any enemies. Harry didn't have any enemies. You know, Harry was a very well called John or come in here any night after 6 o'clock, 6 to 10.
So it's just not troubled youth. It's
the
youth.
These are not all bad kids. Right. I mean, a lot of them are just the parents are in a financial position,
right,
to teach them self-defense, respect. And there's a lot more involved than, you know, being a tough guy. I mean, Kenny McAdams is one of the toughest guys around, but you would never know it by talking to him. But don't deal with him.
Well, I think that's one thing that the people really have to understand. Like you're saying, you're not here to teach them to go out on the streets and beat people up. I mean, that's not your purpose
absolutely
here. Your purpose here is mainly to give them the discipline and really some of the support that some of them that do lack. But I think one big thing what happens a lot of times in these organizations, people have a tendency to think you're a babysitter. You're not a babysitting service for these people.
No.
You're here to work with the kids.
If you can video this whole 4 hours since John's open tonight, there'll be a lot of kids you'll be see doing push-ups. It's because they didn't follow directions of John. And I'm sure that if their parents told them to do push-ups, they'd say, you know, something else.
Bobby, not black that
say
out.
On TV, but, you know, John gains that respect. And if you don't do the push-ups, you know, then John deals with his brother than that, you know. But he don't beat him up. But John does put a lot of respect for him.
Jim, I just want to thank you for having us up here tonight to see the center. And I just want to remind everybody that it's going to be Sunday, is that the 22nd, Jim?
Yeah.
Between 4 and 8, it's at the Teamsters Hall in Collingswood. I think they donated
the hall. John Jackson.
Which is wonderful. And there's still tickets left, so you can call 742-0505.
Yeah. Kenny.
Anybody else? Okay.
Yeah. Kenny's the best one to go see for the second.
And also, important thing is there are no games on the Sunday. Right, there's nothing on the Sunday to people to say, I know I have to stay home and watch the bowl game.
Well, we're going to have a lot of fun up there.
And we have Cozy Morley's going to be there,
Cozy
Jim.
Cozy Morley, the original Temptations. And Kenny's going up here.
And Kenny's going to lip sync. Well, look, we're going to take a break right now, and we'll be right back. Welcome back. This portion is brought to you by the Furry Fence Company, located on Jersey Avenue in Gloucester City. And with us, we have the instructor from the karate school at the Harry P. Furry Memorial Youth Center, and John Alstino.
Right.
I guess right.
Yeah, how you doing?
we were just talking about Harry a little bit. Some of the things, with Jimmy, with some of the things that that your goals are with the youth here.
Of course, the discipline and, to give them some direction, some outlet for their energy. We've done really good here in the neighborhood already. You know, most of the kids in the neighborhood have already joined it. Came in and helped work and clean up, and we started teaching, you know, to be courteous and say yes sir, no sir, and help out when we were in here, and it's been very positive.
What's your enrollment right now?
We got about 50 students.
John, this is long overdue in Gloucester. I think this is wonderful what you're doing, along with Jimmy and all the volunteers that helped out here. I can't praise you enough. You know, I know the kids need this.
Well, Jimmy was telling us that what you do is for disciplinary measures, should they not adhere to the situation or whatever it may be, whether it's bowing or respect, or if you make them do push ups.
Push ups and sit ups, yeah.
Push ups and sit ups. Tom, we'd have been doing push ups and sit ups. We'd be real skinny by now. And if this school was here when we were growing up.
Some of the old schools were very traditional. I used to beat you with bamboo sticks, and there's still a few schools around to do that. But it's
wait, I mean, beating with bamboo sticks? Like Faye? Like that Michael Faye?
Yeah, if the students didn't stand still, you know, they come around with a bamboo stick and just and start beating you with it. But that's kind of counterproductive. What it does, it makes the students afraid of the teacher, and you don't get them to respond as quickly. If I give them discipline in the way of push-ups and sit-ups, they're doing something productive. They're starting to develop their body, you know, through extra exercise, and then they realize they've done something wrong. Plus, you have to explain to them what they've done wrong. You can't just give them arbitrary discipline without explaining to them, you know, what they did wrong.
I feel like an Army drill sergeant. Because look, we're tying up some of these people right now.
Yeah, John, I'd just like to thank you again for everything you've done here, and I hope to see you Sunday night over at the Cozy Morley thing at the Team Fish Hall, and maybe we can join up and do some karate with you.
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
All right.
John, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Again, on behalf of the Harry P. Furry Memorial Youth Center, I'm Brooklyn Bruce, and this is Danny Thomas, Tom McAdams, and thank you, and we'll see you next week.
Hey, you, Elvis.
What?
Look, there's... something, Dick?
No, no.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Good. Going around. Without it, I mean, I can't tell you how much John has done for these students over there at the youth center. And again, John, I don't give you credit face to face, but with this 400 people or better, I'd like to thank you personally, John, and I thank you. Don't expect it daily. Today's social would not be a success if it weren't for the following support. First off, the building that we're in was donated to us by our president, or my president, John J. Jackson, which is the president of the Teamsters Organization. And I commend it. I don't know if John made it here yet, but he is due to come. I think he's supposed to perform with Cozy. But John, if you're not here, I hope everybody stays the fact that I really appreciate what John's done by donating the hall. If you like, you can save all your applause for last, and that way I'll breeze right through this. I do appreciate all the applause that he's had for everybody, but I know you just want to hear Cozy more than you want to hear me. No question about that. My wife wants to get me down here real quick. But Frankie Quinn is a little round guy walking around here that was announcing everybody to come up to eat. Frankie Quinn is one of John's right-hand men here at the hall, and he's certainly top gun here today. With him and his staff, he's done an outstanding job of serving all the food, making sure all the booze was handled right, everything's cold. I'd like to thank, where's Cozy at? Cozy, I'd like to thank you for donating your time tonight. Kenny, you did say he was donating, right? Sorry that your wife, Bobby, couldn't make it, but she has a previous engagement. Am I doing something wrong? What do you say, I'm speaking on the mic? And without a question, the guy that just made the mic stream, Bobby Moore, and the original Temptations. God bless you, Bobby, for all your support. I can also comment the fact that Bobby and his whole family has been personal friends. Fundraising. But if you can support any of these people that I'm giving gratitude to, I think that that's very fitting, because Walt Hines has always got his hand in his pocket and giving money out or reducing his prices. Bill Dougherty, for those that don't know him, he's the top salesman or the manager at Conrad's Beverage. Due to the new liquor laws, they couldn't donate the beer, so they made a very substantial contribution, which I am not privy to donate, but you can support Budweiser. That's why you only see Bud and Bud Light up there, because the Budweiser really went out of their way to help us out. And they always do. I've never called Bill Dougherty and didn't get his support, whether it be financially or for golf tournaments, anything. But he's always been there for the Teamsters picnics. He's been a big help to us. This guy here, I don't think he ever gets paid. Every golf tournament, this function here tonight, if you see a flash go off in your face, he's taking pictures. Jack Marcellus, where you at, Jack? Probably got a flashbulb in your hand. Jack has always, always supported the Harry. And I appreciate it personally, Jack, and I commend you for your support. And if you guys can throw any support to Jack, we need to help those that help us. And the next three guys I'm going to read off, I've just had the privilege of meeting one of them, Bobby Quixel, Bruce Darrow, Kenny's older brother, Tommy McAdams, from video production, for their outstanding job of promoting the youth center on television, and I understand they're videoing tonight, and I appreciate very much what you three guys have done for the youth center, because we've had a lot of comment with your exposures, and I understand if anybody has anything for the youth of Gloucester City, just call these guys up. And Bruce has got all the mouth. Tommy's got all the balls. And Bobby's got all the brains. Did you get that, Bob? You're not putting this on the TV, huh? The ice was donated by Pat. I don't know where Big Pat is. Pat Mace from Mac Ice. Cut it. They're my table saying, get off this table. I'm on my 35th list. Jimmy Mulligan, without him, you wouldn't have a pictures on the table. And thank you, Jimmy. My personal friend, Billy Hargreaves, for his financial support in the nice and fair. Bucky Barron, Barron Fence and Iron. Foster Wheeler for the Trash Esteem. Kenny says he don't want to wrestle this guy. We don't fight him anytime he wants with karate. But Oki Nelson, for the fence company, for his support. He's got a grip like a bear. Greg Weisenbach, Ray Morse, my all-around man, which ain't here all-around. Alice Lippincott and Wally Hearn, which is always there. They're always in the background, but they're always in my support, and I appreciate all the help. This one here, I was told to scratch off here, but I didn't have a pencil to scratch it off, but I'd like to have a special thanks to Kenny's daughter, Patty Bezoir, and my lucky wife. Kenny wrote this down, by the way, for letting Kenny and I put this fair together. Where's my wife, Kay, and Kenny's daughter, Patty? Come on, Kenny. She never was drinking. That ain't her. Please don't forget the barmaid. She's working free tonight for tips. So just put your tips in the cookie jar. And this, I got a lot of reverses here on this, Kenny, but this one here, Kenny said to me, don't do this, no matter what you do, Jim, please don't do it. But I can't honor his wishes. I would like everybody to please give a big round of applause for the chairman, Kenny McAdams. Without him, this would not be a thing. put that in your hat, Kenny. And I thank you personally, Kenny. I'll tell you, without you, this room wouldn't be as full as it is. And I can't thank you enough. Everything we do, Kenny's behind it. Or actually, he's in front of it. We're behind him. Kenny is always the number one in our book. He goes back many, many years, for those that don't know, with Harry. Before I end, I would like to... I use all the ghosts for yourself. I'd like to ask our current mayor and biggest supporter for the youth of Gloucester City and the movement to get Gloucester City forward, Chucky Bellingham. I know he's here somewhere, but I couldn't see him a minute ago. My eyes are crying.
Morning. Cozy just said thanks for coming out tonight. We'll see you next time. I have a few notes here. Believe me, it's not as long as Jimmy's. I want to say, first of all, how honored I am to be here. You know, becoming the mayor of Gloucester City is just, honestly, from the bottom of my heart, the greatest thing that could ever happen here. My family, we're that proud of the city. And I thought that, you know, I'm so proud that I had the opportunity to do something like this. I really thought the greatest moment of my term as mayor was going to be to marry Bill Chasen, but I guess I was wrong. Chief of police, he must be on work release. I'd like to say a few words about my friend Jimmy Ferry. My mother always said, if you have nothing nice to say to anyone, say nothing at all. So I want to thank you. He missed it, he said. Anyway, everyone knows about Jimmy Ferry's generosity. If they don't know about it, they don't know Jimmy Ferry, they've never been around the guy. Here's a guy that I honestly know when it comes to charity. Here's a guy who's never told anyone no. He's told a few people to go to hell, but he's never told anyone no. Okay? I have to be nice to Jimmy. A couple guys come out breaking my legs. Says what he does, never tells people how generous he is. I can go on and on, just tell you about the baseball field, the ponytail league, the minor league, the public works building. Didn't have money in the budget one year, Jimmy put a rail off around the ocean didn't bother us. This guy's charity is honestly endless, and I don't think that anyone who knows Jimmy and anyone in this room knows any differently. I'm very pleased to see this crowd. Everyone talking when Jimmy first started out made me feel good because he knows how we feel at the Democrat Club when he's in the back room with Al DiCiano yapping while I'm trying to give one of my beautiful campaign speeches. Anyway, I have the incredible honor to present Jimmy with a plaque that he doesn't know about, and I'd like to read it for you all. It said, presented to James E. Ferry Sr., in grateful appreciation for your unrelenting pursuit in helping the children of Gloucester City, and in doing so, keeping alive the name and memories of your brother, Harry P. Ferry. Presented by, and this is the greatest honor, Chuck Bellingham, the mayor of Gloucester City.
That our chairman was behind the whole thing, and you're a backstabber, Kenny. So, you know what I mean? You did honor my word, I don't honor yours. Thank you, Kenny. I love you, you know what I mean? But seriously, does anybody need any raffle tickets? If you didn't get a raffle tickets, we got three anxious young fellows up here. Want to sell them to you, put your hand up, and I'll be over here. Did anybody get Cozy Morning? Cozy Morning wants 100 tickets. And we want our mayor to pick them as soon as you guys are done selling them. Before you leave, Chuck, we'd like you to pick them out, please. But Cozy wants a ticket. Has anybody seen Cozy up here? Where's that guy selling tickets at?
The Polish guy's held for free. They got him in the lineup.
They bring the girl in, the Polish guy hops. That's her, officer. Three Polish guys are at the bar and they're drinking champagne and having a hell of a time. So the bartender said, what are you guys celebrating? He says, me and my two brothers put together a jigsaw puzzle in 3 weeks. The bartender said, what's so great about that? He said, on the box, it said 2 to 4 years. You're not going to talk again, are you? Jewish day. Anybody Jewish? One Jew. You want to buy this place here? What a fire. I'll bet they'd have a fire in 3 days here. I could have used you down Wildwood, honest to God. Everybody had a fire but me. I had a flood. I'm trying to light the matches and the waves are coming in. Am I a loser? They cut a girl in half. I get the part that eats. But I swear to God, what the hell kind of country do we have anymore? That Alona Bobbitt, remember that thing? Cut the guys, what do you call it? Like, they had to find that because they didn't want to put him on the milk carton. I was the guy. Can you picture opening up your refrigerator? Have you seen this? World, hey? They had a guy jogging. This was on the news. Guy was jogging across the Potomac the other day. Fell over the bridge. He's drowned. He's in bad shape. Three young guys got in and they pulled him out. Sure enough, it's President Clinton. Well, these three kids were sent. They were in shock. They were in awe. So the president said, my young fellas, I can't thank you enough for saving my life. I was in trouble. I will never forget this. You tell me what you want, son. What can I do for you? He said, anything? He says, I want to go to the Air Force. He said, well, you're going to start tomorrow. You'll be at the college, and I guarantee you your commission. He said to the other kid, what do you want? He said, I want to go to the Naval Academy. He said to the third kid, he said, well, what do you want? He said, I want a burial plot at Arlington National Cemetery. He said, well, why would you want that? He said, when I go home and tell my father who I saved. She's a hard-working waitress, and she's trying to undress to get her outfit out for work. And as she took everything off, he says, my God, hon, you're the most beautiful thing I ever saw. She says, hon, I love you, but you're such a drunk. You're the worst thing ever happened to me. She says, believe me, hon, you've never looked more beautiful. She said, why are you saying that? He said, when you took your bra off and your breast fell down like that, it took all the wrinkles out of your face. Church is called Our Lady of the Courageous Caucasian, huh? And you're raped on the communion table. Is this a wacko world, huh? Hey, my Italians, you know, I tease everybody. I'm afraid of Italian. You say Italian. Hey, well, the good question. I was in an Italian restaurant. I ordered chicken in a basket. Every leg was broken. I got the hell out of there so quick. And they're all lovers. They're all sexy guys. You know? Italian foreplay. Irish foreplay. Let's get another six pack. We are living in a world that is so whacked out. Honestly, God, let me tell you how ridiculous it is. The Pope is in his papal garb. And he lands in New York to do a big function at the Waldorf Astoria, and he's late, and he's very embarrassed. So he jumps in the limousine and said to the driver, please, I'm very, very embarrassed. Get me there. Don't worry. Get me there as quickly as possible. Well, the driver's a little apprehensive. He's stopping at the red light, 15 miles an hour. The Pope said, stop. You get in the back, and I'm driving. He's singing through Broadway. A big Irish cop pulls him over, saw the Pope, didn't know what the hell to do. He called the cop. He called his sergeant. He said, Sarge, I don't know how to handle this. I got to do my job, but the guy is so important. I can't give him a ticket for speeding. He said, nail him. He said, but please, sir, listen to me. He's very important. He said, what do you mean important? How big is big? Is he bigger than the mayor? He said, he's bigger than Giuliano. He's bigger than the governor. And he's bigger than Clinton. He said, well, how big is he? He said, I don't know how big he is, but the Pope's driving him. I said, did you lose a shoe? He said, no, I found one. Are these kids whacked out? Thank you. That's a nice thing you're doing. That's the kids are great, but they're nuts today, you know? You know what makes me laugh with the young kids? They dress like we had to. You ever notice that? They go out and buy the things we were ashamed to wear. I said to my grandson, you're a goofball kid. He said, let me teach you the way the nuns taught me. I said, if I had 10 apples and I took 5 away, what's the difference? He said, that's what I said, what's the difference? I said, who invented the first light? He said, Budweiser. The little girl is 9, she's learning sex education. I said, hon, what are they teaching you? She says, stay out of intersections and buy condominiums. The big guy, he goes to college. He came back, he said, I can't find myself. If I ever said that to my father, he would have hit me with a club and said, now you're not lost. It's sick. This guy had a real bad stutter, you know, and he went to the doctor, and he said, a little embarrassed, he wants to try to talk to the guy next to him while they're waiting for the doctor. He said, what's wrong with you? The guy said, hey, fella, that's real. I have prostate trouble, and it's killing me. He said, what happens with that prostate trouble? He said, I pee like you talk. Is this a sick world? You better laugh or Jimmy will be back with some more information. Another 2 days of information. Everybody got a plug with the guy that picked up the cigarette butts outside. The whole goddamn work. Hey, you want to see funny people, huh? And I'm coming close to this thing here. Senior citizen homes. Have you ever been to these homes? The old guy. All they do is bitch and complain. That's why you girls outlive us. Look at how great you look. When's the last time you saw a busload of widowers? Think about that. You always see a busload of widows, and they're all going to the casino. Come on, man, get up there. Come on. Let's get in the seat. One old guy is trying to get on the bus. He's the driver, you know. I honestly, they're great people. One old guy got the Preparation H mixed up with the Bengay. I said, how the hell did you find out? He said, my shoulders were getting swollen. So the doctor showed up in the morning, he said, how's it working? He said, for all the good it did, I kind of stuck it up my ass. I am running for mayor. I love you girls, I swear to God. When we were kids, I love my young friends, but we had more fun with no money. When I was a kid, on my prom, I couldn't even get the girl in a corsage. I went up to Holy Cross Cemetery. I left the ribbons and all on. Mother, father, Uncle George, Cousin Johnny. She had a bouquet, they couldn't even see how lovely she was. Are these kids back out today? Are there any teachers out here? How the hell can you teach these kids if they're unruly? There's no discipline. You know, you can't hit them, they hit you back. She said to the little Irish boy, you're all making noise. And she said, John, what does your dad do? He said, my dad is a carpenter and he fixes things. And as the kid went on, they got quiet. So the teacher said, my God, I got their attention. I got their little minds working. Well, tell me about your dad. He said, he fixes things, and I hold the hammer for my dad. He went on, and she said, terrific. So she had a little Italian boy. She said, Mario, what does your dad do? She said, my dad's a doctor. He helps everybody if you're sick. And he went on, so she said, the little Polish kid. She said, Stanley, what does your dad do? She said, my daddy's dead. She said, well, what did he do before he died? He said, Kmart. The laces are still tied together. Did you ever go to a Puerto Rican funeral? They put the body in a stolen car in a towaway zone. Even the church. I want the mass this morning. They got rid of the Holy Ghost. There's a guy who never hurt nobody that day. I want the Holy Ghost. The other guy, all he did was fly around. He didn't bother nobody. One guy was so drunk he got in the confessional. After a couple of minutes, he yelled, "You got any paper on your side?" In the church. And let me tell you something, I'm not prejudiced. I'm Irish, but I am not prejudiced. Jesus was Irish. I was alive. He was 32, unmarried, living with his mother. He couldn't have been a Jew, because he would have never went to the Last Supper, he would have went to the early bird. Jewish lady went up to the cemetery to visit her husband's grave. The caretaker said, "What's his name?" She said, "Jacob Rosenberg." He looked through the list. He said, "There's no Jacob, there's a Becky." She said, "That's him. Everything's in my name." Don't they have the right idea, that King of Jews? How come the Irish aren't smart? When I was in Ireland, they were so drunk they had a fire squad. They were all in a circle. Who the hell are they going to shoot over here? When you die, they bury you with your backside sticking up. That's where they park the bike. You just go right there. One Irish guy wanted to join the IRA. He said, "You won't blow up that British bus." He burned his mouth on the exhaust pipe. They're demolishing this old Polish home, and they found a skeleton in a closet with a big medallion around his neck. It said, "Polish hide and seek champion." Polish hide and seek champion. I'm bringing Jimmy back. You better laugh. I didn't get much out of this. The Polish guy's house is on fire. He calls the fire department. He said, "Well, how do we get there?" He said, "Don't you have the big red trucks anymore?" "Don't you have the big red trucks?" And in the rack of my favorite Polish guy. Two lifeguards. One's Polish, one's Italian. And all the girls are going for the Italian. So the Polish kid said, "Tony, look, what the hell's wrong with me? I'm built nice. I got a nice personality. I don't mind spending a buck. How come the girls don't go for me?" He said, "Forget that other stuff. Do what I do. Put a potato down your bathing suit." They're on the beach the next day. All the girls are going for the Italian. Nothing but a Polish kid. He said, "What am I doing wrong?" He said, "You got to put the potato in the front." Communities that I've ever been associated with. I think Gloucester is the best. Even with Philly Chase living here, I'm telling you. I've brought it down a little bit, but not that much. I tell you, he's a good, Philly just got engaged, did you know? I tell you, isn't that nice? To those six girls sitting at that table, every one of them thinks they're going to marry that wacko. I tell you, I went to a nudist wedding. Did you ever go to a nudist wedding? The minister said to the girl, "Do you take this man?" She said, "No, I'll take that guy over there." What the hell up here? The Irish, they have a party. Funerals, we love funerals, the Irish. They hear a guy sick, they have a funeral or something. Let's have a party, right? They're all cockeyed drunk, you know. I went to one funeral, the guy was never sober, he had him cremated, he burned for 9 months. His wife got the ashes and put him in an egg timer. She said he never worked when he was alive, but he'll work now. He's a 3-minute egg in Boston. They're my people, you know. The Irish guy won the lottery. He called his wife, he says, I won the lottery, now get your bags packed. She said, for the summer or the winter. He says, I don't care as long as you're out in the morning. Were you ever in Ireland? I'll tell you, they're all different fun. In church, they're all drunk in church, and the girl in the choir had an epileptic fit, and she fell off, she's hanging on the guardrail. I looked up, she had no undergarments. Well, the priest saw this. He says, if any man looks up there, he'll be struck blind. This old guy said, I think I'll risk one eye. See, there's nothing funny about an Italian. There's nothing funny about an Italian. Guess what? You know the three shortest books in the library? You go to the library, the first, the skinniest book of all is Italian War Heroes. That's the smallest. And the next one is Famous Irish Chefs. And the second one is Jewish Philanthropists. Those Jews, that's a... what the hell does it matter? Is this a new world? This guy had a big truck in Fort Lauderdale, and he pulls onto a condominium lot. He parks his big truck and goes to walk away. A little lady comes down on the balcony with no clothes on. Mr. Kitchy, you and I, let's have some fun. Get up here, I'll give you a good time. He flew upstairs. She said, get my apartment and take everything off. He's standing there with nothing on. She said, put your thing on the table. She got a little hammer. She said, never, ever park in my spot. But the seniors, I love the seniors, especially the guys. Are they a piece of work, you know? The old lady's 92 and the doctor wants to tease her. He says, May, do you still have intercourse? She says, I don't know. I'll ask my husband. She said, Charlie, do we have intercourse? He said, no, Blue Cross of Asia Medical. Just say these three words. How do you feel? My kidneys is wrapped around my knees, and when I burp, I can't get up the goddamn makeup. Then I can't hear. Then the telephone, then I can't get up the product. 3 hours, you know. I'll tell you, the chief of police, he can tell you some court trials. You can't believe the way the courts are functioning. It was a divorce action, and the judge came out and said, I'm going to give this girl $3,000 a week. And the husband said, great, I'll throw in a couple bucks myself. This is in the court. This is the court. One couple, she was 92, he was 97, and they're getting a divorce. And the judge said, why now? She said, we waited for the kids to die. They find him $100. He said, oh, you got $100. They said, well, how are you going to get it? He said, can I go out in the hall for a couple of minutes? Nobody cares. Everybody, whatever happened, it just being nice, you know? I'm in New York. I said to this old guy, that's a big funeral, sir. I wonder who died. He said, I think the guy in the first car. I'm in Chicago waiting for the bus. I said to this guy, how long is the next bus? He said, 52 feet. Who the hell needs this? guys. They're my favorite. You know, the lady's very, very sick. She's in very, very bad shape. So the doctor said, sweetheart, wait in the ante room. I want to talk to your husband. So the husband came in, he said, Jack, he said, you've got a sick little girl. Now, you could do a lot to help her. Make love to her every night. Tell her you love her. Put your arms around her. Caress her. Make a couple of meals. Console her. Tell her how much she means to you, or she's going to die. He walked outside. She said, what did he say? He said, you're going to die. Well, why don't you know what he was talking about? He's going to steal paper, that little whack. He's a paper stealer if I ever saw one. Even toilets. Whatever happened. Was it a simple men's room or ladies' room? Now it's kings and queens, seniors and senoritas, chiefs and scores, pointers and centers, uppers and downers. I was in a seafood restaurant. The bathrooms were clams and oysters. I almost wet myself before I found out I was a clam. I don't even look like a clam. You want to see it? Here they go. Every girls go two at a time. Guys go by themselves. They don't need no help. What the hell are you doing that you need somebody to help you with? You girls are the best. The guys, this old guy, he was saying, shut the hell up, lady. What the hell makes your noise over there? Give her her ticket back. Get her the hell out of here. The old guy, he was lethargic, he wasn't doing nothing, you know, he was just sitting around. So his wife said, I gotta steam this old guy up. So she went to the Go-Go Girls in the Yellow Pages, super sex. She said, that's the company for me. She called, she said, send me a sexiest little boy, put some life into my old fart, will you? Get him to do something. So this girl is beautiful, voluptuous, she rings the bell, he opens the door, she said, super sex. He says, I'll just take the soup. He sits down, he's the same size as when he's standing up. Look at him. See, he didn't get up there. Look how small he is. Yeah, I love you. Hey, move it, come clutch if you can. The Second World War, the German general and the Italian general were surrounded with the Allied troops. So the German general jumped up, he said to his adjutant, Fritz, get my red coat. He said, sir, why do you want the red coat? He said, if I am shot, the blood will run out on the red coat. The men will not see the blood. They will fight to the death for the fatherland. So the Italian general jumps up. He said to his adjutant, Tony, get my brown pants. Wait till I start my car tonight with this Italian. This prostitute ended up in a room with a Chinese. And they're making love, and the Chinese jumps out of bed and he goes, I'm done. Look at the name. And then he fell on the floor and he rolled under the bed. Then he jumped in bed again. He started making love. He jumped out of bed. I'm done. Look at the name. Under the bed, in the bed. This is going on for 5 hours. The girl said, this guy is a gorilla. From exhausted, she fell out of bed, rolled under the bed, and bumped into 12 Chinese. You can't tell them a word. The world is sick and it's going to get sicker. Our Lady of Lourdes Hospital, Chinese couple, Mr. and Mrs. Wong, they want to get their little baby, they wheel out a white baby. So Mr. Wong said, no, two Wongs and I'll make a white. Two Wongs and I'll make a white. Hey, I love, hey, you're a troll, nice to meet you. What the hell, you know, this girl had little breasts. She had real little breasts. And the husband said, look, honey, please, this is kind of silly. Stop talking about your breast. I didn't marry your breast, or your belly button, or your toenails. I married you. I love you. She said, honey, I know you love me, but for my self-esteem, I don't feel like a woman. I'm going to Dr. Schwartz. He said he could help me. He said, so the guy, he said, no. So she went to Dr. Schwartz, and he said, your husband's a knight. I'm not going to cut you off. No surgery, though. A simple thing like breathing exercises. Now, God didn't help you. Nature didn't help you. Help yourself. All you have to do is inhale. Now, don't exhale. Build up this tension and stretch your arms. Mary had a little lamb. His fleece was white as snow. Everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. As you breathe and extend, it forces these muscles out. You do this as many times a day. Hold your breath. Build it up. You're going to look great. So she's starting to look really great. So she's in a restaurant. She said, honey, I'm doing the exercises. She said, not the restaurant. She stood up. She said, Mary had a little lamb. His fleece was white as snow. Everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. So the guy at the bar, honey, you went to Dr. Schwartz. She said, how do you know? He said, one potato, two potatoes. Two little faggots. Get the hell back there. Little faggot. Look, he's going to fill up the pitcher in the toilet. Hey, what the hell are we drinking? This guy's urine? Hey, I love you. Honestly, God. You know, I've been doing it. This is like 54 years for me. South Philly. Anybody know South Philly? Who'd ever think they'd have summer homes at Front and Bainbridge? You ever read it? Frank Rizzo and I were kids. Frank Rizzo, when he was a cop, he found a dead horse at Shackamaxon. That's a street in Philly. He dragged his horse up to Burke's because he couldn't spell Shackamaxon. I went to Catholic school, little school, Sacred Heart, Mac and Hart and Mary. Do you ever go back to the old nuns that you were frightened of? They're this big, honest to God. I thought you were 8 foot 8. We had a Jewish kid, my next door neighbor, Shanky Prusak, in Carsville in a public school. Put him in a Catholic school, he's terrific. His mother said, son, you're Jewish. How come you're so good in the Catholic school? He says, Mom, I'm not taking any chances in there. They got a guy nailed to the wall in every room. Did that scare the hell out of you? What happened to your hair? Look at the belly on this guy. You won't even be able to see it. He's going to pee on his kneecap, this guy. Oh, look at that thing sticking out there. I know who he's with, the lady with the flat chest, that's who she is. To you, fella. Look at this little part. Look at this part. You're the best. Hey, you're the fun to laugh at yourself. Break down your inhibitions. I'm telling you, just let it all hang out. Life's going to be real short. You got to just enjoy yourself. You know, when we were kids, really, honest God, my young friend, I set the hell down. What the hell is this, a reunion here? Do we have any money? I'm going to be 70. Do we have any money when we were kids? Do we have the best times? I tell you, on Christmas Eve, my father went out on the step with a gun. He went bang. The committee said, Santa Claus committed suicide. Oh, jeez. My mother, for Easter, she couldn't even afford to buy me a suit. She put me a hat and let me look out the window. A guy with a shirt and tie? I bet he's got 30 shorts. Let me see your shorts. Sure. Oh, this guy wants to know if table 20 can eat.